My wife saw her first porn the other day. Let me rephrase that. My wife caught me watching porn the other day.
Every man in this room has turned to porn at some point in time. Stupidest shit that a man can do. Here's why I say it's stupid. We don't give people that do porn enough credit and enough respect. Those people are professional actors and actresses. That's what they do for a living. You can't just watch that shit and go home and try it. It don't work like that. That's like watching a karate movie, going outside, getting in a fight, telling everybody to back up so you can roundhouse kick this nigga in the head. You don't know how to do that kick. It's the same thing with porn. I'm not speaking to you from a hypothetical place. I've been there. I've done it. I've tried it. I watched porn with my wife. Tried to do the shit that I saw. I was nervous about it. So I was having a conversation with myself. Should I do it? Should I fucking do it? Should I try it? I had good Kevin on this side. Bad Kevin was on this side. Good Kevin popped up. Good Kevin had on a pair of khakis and a V-neck sweater. He said, absolutely not. Don't do it. As a good woman, you talk to her first. Bad Kevin popped up. Bad Kevin had on a pair of leather pants and a fishnet tank top, and he was doing this. Bad Kevin. Bad Kevin said, you gonna listen to a man with khakis on? No, no. He said, do it then, do it. Out of nowhere, I spit on my wife. Puh, it's quick. Right in her fucking forehead. Puh. A loogie right in her goddamn forehead. It was an awkward beat of silence. Nobody said nothing. It was quiet. Out of nowhere, she was like, you just fucking spit on me! The complete opposite reaction from the lady in the porn. The lady in the porn went crazy when it happened. She was like, this spit making me so hot, this spit gonna make me come, In my mind, I was like, that's how you make them come. You gotta spit on their fucking hands. I've been doing it wrong all this time. I haven't told my wife, you're not doing it right. You gotta rub it in, that's how you fucking come. I had to go downstairs, get a baby wipe, clean her head off. That was embarrassing. I go to get back in the bed, she wanna talk about it. What did I tell you guys? I don't like to talk. Let it float in the air and disappear. I don't wanna talk about it. As soon as I get in the bed, she was like, did you really just spit on me? I almost lied. I almost lied. Even though I know that she know that I know I did it, I almost fucking lied. The reason why is because Bad Kevin popped back up. Bad Kevin was like, say it was a leak in the ceiling. I said, now get the hell out of here, Bad Kevin. Yes, yes, I spit on you. Why? I don't know. I was watching porn. I saw some shit. I tried it. She said, Kevin, let me tell you something. I don't care if you watch porn. Don't be stupid enough to bring the shit that you saw in our house. She said, I watch porn all the time. I don't try to do the shit that I saw to you. I said, back the fuck up. When did this become a whorehouse? The hell you mean you watching porn? What the hell are you watching? She was like, everything. Instantly, it got hurt. The reason why it hurt me is because I fucking couldn't separate my pride from reality. This is a problem that all men have. See, reality is if she wanna watch porn, she can watch porn. If I wanna watch porn, I can watch porn. That's how it should be. But my pride wouldn't let it be that way. My pride wanted to know what she was watching. I wanna see it. Let me see it with my eyes. I wanna see it. She said, you wanna see it? Let me see it. She got a laptop, opened it up. She said, my porn search is in my cookies. All you gotta do is search my cookies. I said, well, you better get me a glass of milk because I'm about to eat all these goddamn cookies. The shit that I saw hurt my heart. It hurt me. The reason why is because her porn search was a complete opposite of who I am. Everything I saw was big. Everything was big. Big balls to the walls, big backs on big blacks, big cocks and socks. What the fuck is going on? One of the sites wasn't even porn. One of the sites was a bunch of tall men being active. They were changing light bulbs, putting shit on shelves, hanging paintings. What kind of sick shit is this? What the fuck is this? She was like, what? You can't do none of that stuff. I like that stuff. Ow! So
I know I have to lose some weight, but I want to be careful because I don't want to lose too much and end up in porn. Because you know that is a very real possibility. If you're hot, if you're super attractive, like you are, you're proper hot, right? Like you're a beautiful couple. Do you work out together? Yeah. Of course you do. I'm not fit shaming you, but you're a hot couple. Like aesthetically, you're quite pleasing to the eye. Like if you two came up to me in a bar and asked me for a threesome, I'd be in. Yeah. And not just in a hold the camera kind of way, I'll give it my all. I would get so freaky. You two would be super impressed. Like halfway through, over my naked butt, you'd just be high-fiving each other going, fucking score on this one, eh? But you have to be careful. Because you're beautiful, you could end up in porn. The rest of you, you're fine. No, because you know, if you're in a happy, healthy relationship and you've got a healthy sex life, at some point, one of you will turn to the other and go, we should record ourselves. You know, while we're, you know. And you will. If you're going, we'll never do that. Your partner's probably already doing it. You may as well get involved. There's a whole genre of porn of you not being in porn, so you may as well. And then you're going to go, okay, fine. And you're going to take your smartphone, you'll prop it up somewhere in the room. And then you go at it. You go at it hammer and tongs, right, Lee? You give it your A game because you know you're recording yourself. Right? And then afterwards you go, okay, go get it. He rolls off you, he goes and he gets it, comes back and you're excited. Right? You're like, oh, this is going to be good. This is going to be great. You're like, I love you. And you hit play. Why is my asshole so dark? Why is it so hairy? It looks like a tarantula's crawling out of a cave. You look at your body at an angle you wouldn't normally see it. Performing an activity you wouldn't normally see reflect back in a shop front window. You see things on your body that you wouldn't normally see. You look at that and you go, is that a nipple on my back? And your partner's like super blasé. You go, yeah, I thought you knew. You're like, no, every time it's cold, I think it's a fucking label on my cardigan. And he's like, no, no. And when it's really hot, it does that weird Barbie mouse thing that... You look at that footage, it's not natural. It's your fat, pasty-ass white body plowing at pace into another fat, pasty-ass white body, meeting abruptly in the middle. It doesn't even sound good. Like in the heat of the moment, you don't hear anything. But when it's silent and you're just staring at your white body with an extra nipple on a little screen, all you can hear... Like, what is that noise? Oh, it's your balls on my tummy. You look at that and you go, why am I fucking you? Why are you fucking me? You go, let's never do this shit again.
My wife saw her first porn the other day. Let me rephrase that. My wife caught me watching porn the other day. In the worst way anyone's ever gotten caught watching porn. I guarantee it. 11:30 on a Tuesday afternoon. I'm in the closet. Now, I don't even know how it started. I don't know how I got into it. All of a sudden, I'm in it, though. I'm on my phone scrolling because I broke my governor when I was a kid, and now nothing turns me on. I'm like, give me a tentacle or quicksand, something real. Knock the wind out of someone, something I can gravitate to. I hear her walking in the closet, Phone in the pocket. She didn't see that. She looks at me and says, what were you just doing on your phone? I'm on my heels. I got this. I go, I was replying to work emails. She goes, really, are you sure you weren't watching a video called No Mercy for My Throat? Now I'm thinking that is really specific for a guess. But I stood my ground. I go, no. And she goes, dickhead, your phone's tethered to the TV in the bedroom. She had been watching me flip through all the porns I deemed boring. What, girl on girl, what is this, eighth grade? Guy, girl, what am I, gay? Come on, give me something real. Ooh, no mercy for my throat. I'm listening. And this was not for the faint of heart. This was not entry-level porn. This was mascara running. Like, You know the kind of blowjobs where they have to come up for air, just... She's like, what the fuck is that? I'm like, that is a blowjob.